good afternoon, good evening, and good night.
I'm just a reptile amphibian expert. But yeah, this guy's just chilling, enjoying the sun like we all do in the Sunshine State.
Spot. Exactly. This spot. With Hunt's de Leon.
Alright, but
found the fountain of youth.
Seriously though, it would be great to see a 5-foot-plus Eastern Diamondback rattlesnake.
Good evening. And welcome to another episode of A Couple of Guys Go Look at Stuff. We have been gone for a while. I moved to like Florida.
He's a Florida man.
I'm Clay behind the camera. This is my friend Peter and my friend Seth. And we've met in Chicago when we went to college. And now we're here in Florida.
Yes, sir, Florida.
Had a broken computer for a while.
Uh-huh.
And I have a new computer. I was doing some like Disney short videos for a while. And I think some people enjoyed it. Other people probably hate me for it. But I won't be doing that anymore. I'm done at Disney World.
Disney's over. Right now, this is Lettuce Lake Park, just not too far away from Tampa. A lot of alligators here, so a lot of good wildlife.
Seth is going to become the new...
herpetologist, the study of reptiles and amphibians.
I was going to say crocodile hunter, but...
There you go, that's fine.
Peter's going to wrangle a snake.
Yeah.
It's going down.
The danger is real, the stakes are high.
Well, that's okay. You got to add a little danger to your life. You know what I mean? Too many of these people, they just sit around, they worry about things all the time, and it's ridiculous.
A little bit of danger in my life.
You got to have a little adventure. You know what I mean?
A little bit of gabagoo.
Seriously, what are you going to do? Just sit around at home scratching your balls in front of the television for the next 30 years eating Wendy's? I mean, come on now. You got to have a little adventure and danger. You know what I mean?
There's going to be a little bit of Italy in this video. I'm pretty sure Seth is like a part of the mafia.
Non lo so di questo, ma io solo mi piace di vivere
in una demon, everyone run!
In una via che con un po' pericolo della vita mia. Perché si deve avere l'avventura e il pericolo della vita.
Domine!
È molto più divertente e interessante così.
So, you know, thanks for hanging out with us today. If you like what you see, give us a thumbs up.
Certo.
Everyone's all about that thumbs up.
Si.
And if you want, you can subscribe.
You better subscribe!
You can like,
or Seth will come get
turn
you.
The notification bell on if that's your jam.
La campana da notificazione.
You can follow us at eFilms Travel. We're on Facebook and Instagram.
Bella.
Bellissima, questo serpente bellissima.
Ciao bella.
Mi piace moltissimo di vedere i rettili.
Ciao bella, principessa.
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 Not principessa.
I wanted you here from my family. You have decided to interrupt
quelle lunghissime
wildlife over
no,
here.
Man. Look at this. This is just, oh my goodness. Like I said, there weren't any people around. I jumped down there, just explore around that tree. You gotta break the rules every now and then. Add a little danger to your life. But yeah, there's definitely a perfect place for snakes to be curled up all over there. Very nice.
This wonderful boardwalk is brought to you by Red Bull.
Oh, look, right there. Chilling, lazily enjoying the sun.
Chilling like a villain.
That's right. He's about 4 feet long, juvenile, typical American alligator, also called Mississippi alligator. In the state of Florida, there's over 1 million alligators alone, meaning just in the state alone. Then on the extreme southern tip of the state, you got the American crocodiles, which is the only place in the world where the gators and the crocodiles coexist. They're making a steadily comeback. There's about 2,000 of them. But yeah, this guy's just chilling, enjoying the sun like we all do in the Sunshine State.
good. But yeah, great place. Hopefully we'll see the Eastern Diamondback rattlesnakes.
Would you consider yourself a gator expert?
I don't know about expert, but I mean, I'd say I'm a, yeah, I guess so partially, I'm just a reptile amphibian expert.
Yeah, would you like the nickname the Gator Man?
Sure.
Gator Man.
Sure.
Knowing about gators and all that stuff. Gator Man.
I want to see another snake. We've probably passed several of them, I'm sure, because of, you know, all the critters that are underneath this boardwalk. You just gotta really keep your eyes peeled for the snakes. Pete, why don't you try to scale this tree? Or wait, should we go back? Pete, I think that guy wants you, that gator chilling on the log, I think he wants you to scratch his chin. Somewhere outside of Orlando, there's an invasive population of monkeys. I forget what they're called, but it's a species from South America. Yes, there are. And they're
just like in the city.
This has been learning stuff with Seth.
Yeah. Usually within the more, you know, rural shrub areas. And they're nasty.
Some more animal trivia.
Yeah.
Do you know what the most invasive species in Brazil is?
I don't actually.
The hippopotamus.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Pablo Escobar owned four
hippos. Oh yeah, that's right. That is how they got
there. They didn't know how to do it, and now there's like 2,000 of them.
That's right. But yeah, Clayton, do you think Pete should go back there to scratch that gator's chin?
I think Pete should take it out on a date.
Take it out on a date, huh?
Only treat it to the finest food.
Benissimo.
My buddy Polly, he'll hook us up real good. Real good.
Imagine, okay, questo finest, sarebbe buono.
Finest mostaccioli you've ever seen. This side of the Mississippi.
Si pronuncia mostaccioli. Le lumache.
Is the that lumaches. An offensive gesture?
Si. Certo, perché oggi in questi giorni tutti sono offensivo.
Like actual people from Italy, and they do this all the time.
È vero.
What does that mean?
It's just like when we do this stuff.
È solo un modo di parlando per espressione. Sono un popolo molto molto espressivo.
What's the translation?
I said it's all just for expression, because they're a very expressive people. Lasciatemi cantare, perché ne sono fiero. Sono l'italiano. Io spero che c'è un serpente a sonaglio di mangiare questi scoiattoli. So I hope there's a rattlesnake that'll come to eat these squirrels.
Bippity boppity. Bippity boppity.
So Seth.
Si, dimmi.
Are there different kinds of alligators?
No, there's in
Florida,
the continental U.S. No, there's just the one major species, the American alligator, which are also called Mississippi gator, and then in Central and South America, there's this species of crocodilian called caiman. Caiman are like a smaller version of alligators, which I actually saw a few of them in Argentina when I was down there for a mission trip. Yep,
my sister was down there.
Bellissimo, in un bel paese. Mi piace molto di esplorare la giungla.
What about crocodiles?
Crocodiles, so there's the American crocodile, which lives here in the extreme southern tip of Florida. And there's various species of crocodiles in Africa, most notably the Nile crocodile. There's also various species of them in Southeast Asia and Australia. And then there's the saltwater crocodile, which is the biggest species of crocodilian in the world. You can get up to 20 feet long.
That's pretty big.
Yes, it is. I think the one on record was 23.
And are these trees, like, do they keep the,
like,
prevent the ground from, like, having erosion?
Yes, yeah, and these are called the cypress trees. I portray these trees in a lot of my landscape oil paintings.
They're old.
Yep.
Old.
Seth is a man of many hobbies.
È proprio vero. This is very true.
He's what we like to call a renaissance man.
Sì, l'uomo del rinascimento.
A little bit of everything.
È proprio vero.
He's the reincarnation of Leonardo da Vinci.
Preferisco invece Michelangelo, ma anche questo considera un buon complimento.
He prefers Michelangelo.
Sì.
He finds it more of a compliment.
I said I prefer Michelangelo, but this is still a good compliment.
I was close. I'll try to translate the whole time.
Look, he's got the leaves all over him.
It's one over here. It's small.
Is he trying to blend in? Or?
Yeah, and they're just chilling too and soaking up the heat because they're ectothermic, meaning their body temperature is dependent on the surroundings. They can't, like, you know, curl up and put their arms around themselves to stay warm. So they're just absorbing as much heat. So right now they're really slow and sluggish.
Sorry. Seth Nye, the Florida guy.
So yeah, endothermic means cold-blooded. Okay, so here's something else that's cool. You know why they're named alligators in the first place? So when Juan Ponce de Leon came here with his men, they saw these creatures. He's the first European to set foot in Florida. And they called them El Largatos, which in Spanish literally means the lizard. Then eventually got the English derivative, just alligator. El Largatos, alligators.
And then he found the Fountain of Youth.
Yep. I mean, and they basically are. They're just oversized lizards, pretty much.
And he turned into an alligator.
Mm-hmm.
This is what the government doesn't want to tell you.
Oh, he got something. He got a crayfish.
I need you to contact.
Look at that. The see, it's waving man. Its claws around. He just got a crayfish to be. Crunch.
Oh. He's gonna have one of them crawfish balls.
Oh, no. He got it. He'll get it. Gulp.
Pictures. My gosh.
La Florida e l'Italia sono le più bellissime penisole.
Here we have the natural predator of wildlife.
Bush.
Okay. Be very careful here. Everybody stay back. I'm trained. I don't know if you can see him in there.
What is that?
He's right there. He's right there.
It's a Coke can.
The natural predator of all nature.
La spazzatura.
Trash.
See.
Stop dumping your Coke can. Random places.
The garbage can.
It's a PSA.
30 feet away from you.
And a good shot of its butt.
It's looking sad in South America.
Armadillo. That's my wife.
I was walking in the woods one day. Peter and Clayton saw something strange. A little leaping Seth that liked to bounce and play.
You got
they
that right, bro.
Bouncing friend, we would go, the adventure will end. Little farts are creeping just around the bend. Where's he going? Listen to the farts. I don't know. Where did he start? Me and Clay are following Seth. He just keeps on farting loud. Probably gonna run away. Me and Clay and our friend Seth. He just keeps on farting now. So me and Clayton are out of town.
We are at Honeymoon Island.
Yes, sir.
On the Gulf Coast.
Yep.
Near Tampa.
That's right. Dunedin.
Tampa, Florida.
More so Dunedin.
It's like a conservation state park area. Or is it a state park?
Yes, it is.
State park.
Ooh, look, Seth's taking his Instagram.
So Seth.
What's that?
Tell us about armadillos.
So there are, I think there's about 30 species of them. The only species that lives in the continental U.S. is the nine-banded armadillo. All the others live in Central and South America. The biggest species is the fairy armadillo, which lives down in the jungles of South America. They can get like up to 4 to 5 feet long. And of those like 30 plus species, I think it is,
The nine-banded armadillo is the only one, along with human beings. Human beings and nine-banded armadillos are the only creatures on the planet that can contract leprosy. So you definitely don't want to touch them. They're cute little guys. The name Armadillo in Spanish means little armored one because of their skin and just of how their body structure is overall, but they're cute little guys. Unique features. I always enjoy seeing them. They're nocturnal during this time of day, the evenings when they come out on this gorgeous island. Really hoping to see the EDRs, Eastern Diamondback Rattlesnakes.
Reptile dysfunction.
What's
medicine?
That?
Rendezvous?
Wait, what's that? Rendezvous, what?
What's it? What's an EDR?
Eastern Diamondback Rattlesnake. Oh. EDR, Eastern Diamondback Rattlesnake.
One of the new Florida drugs.
Kratom?
Kratom, Batum, and Atum.
Kratom, Batum, Atum. No doubt back in the day, the 17th century, there were pirates that chilled out here. I have seen the great horned owls here with the big yellow eyes. They're very impressive birds of prey. I've also seen a few bald eagles here before. The main population for the birds of prey are the ospreys. You see a lot of them here. And it's like, watch out for these fellow hikers.
Oh.
Hello.
Yo.
Oh, go ahead. It's just a dumb little video. It's no big deal. Do you guys see any critters?
Yep.
You did?
All right, back to our dumb video.
I'm just kidding, Clayton. So, the first thing. Careful, Peter.
It was on this spot, exactly this spot, where Ponce de Leon found the Fountain of Youth.
Seriously, though, be careful if you're near the brush, because if you get bit, we're not exactly that close to civilization.
I'm a medical professional. I can handle myself in nature.
In the state of Illinois.
In the state of Illinois. Here, I don't know what kind of magic they use, so I can't fix anyone.
There's also a lot of gopher tortoises on this island. They're so named because they burrow underground. They have very strong front legs with spurs on them so they can dig, and a very determined tortoise can dig 40 feet under the ground. The gopher tortoises are what's known as a keystone species, meaning that if there's
like Pennsylvania.
Correct, yes. If there's a good population of gopher tortoises, then that means there's a lot of other substantial habitat for a variety of other creatures, because a lot of other creatures like to cohabitate in the burrow with the tortoise, such as field mice, toads, the frogs, and one of my favorite creature, the Eastern Diamondback Rattlesnake. They all curl up in there and they share the chambers of the burrow with the tortoise.
No, Seth, it's all about the Western Diamondbacks.
The Eastern Diamondbacks are much more pretty.
Mm-hmm.
They blend in, they have like a goldish brownish color to blend in with the leaf litter. Western Diamondbacks are also known as Coontail Rattler because they have black and white stripes at the base, at their tail, and they have like a more dull grayish brownish color to blend in with the rocks and the sand in the Southwest deserts. And here the Eastern Diamondbacks have like golden black rings around their tail. They blend in with the leaf litter.
That's why me and Clayton are wearing our tactical boots.
And I got the laced up Nikes.
Near Bethany Beach.
Where is that, up north in Florida?
No, it's in Delaware.
Oh, Delaware? Delaware. I haven't been there in years. Shoot, I haven't been there since.
They have a disc golf course. It's all in the sand.
That's cool. Bethany Beach. Wow, I haven't been to Delaware since 1996. It's been a very long time.
It was 1942. Seth?
Yes?
Was a mere 13 years old.
That's right.
He was sitting in his office one day. He had a cigar.
Right.
Broad came in, blonde hair. And she goes, "Hey, are you Detective Seth?" And he says, "Yeah, da, I am." And he goes looking for clues all over the place. And then one day, he found nothing. And at the end of his career, he had it in his badge and his gun. Captain said, "You're done, Seth, get out." And he ain't been back since. True story.
In Delaware?
Yeah.
All right, Seth, what am I looking at?
So there were, at the surface, they're called fiddler crabs. They're so named because the male has one really big claw that's bigger than its own body and a little claw, and it kind of looks like it's holding or playing a fiddle. The females just have two tiny little sized claws, and the males use that big claw to fight with one another for territory.
And they burrow in the ground here?
Yep. Yeah, I've grabbed them before. You just gotta be fast.
seems to be doing some sort of mating call.
Can you cut it for a sec? Just stop filming for a sec.
What?
We're not live.
What's that?
We're not live.
We're not live. You can edit everything.
Oh, okay, then go ahead. Sorry, I thought you were live. Anyways, okay, you can resume.
There's no one watching us right now.
Here's a wild Seth emerging from the bush. All right, Seth, what's the biggest animal you're gonna find out here?
It would be great to see a 5-foot-plus eastern diamondback rattlesnake. Ever since I was 9 years old, it's always been on my bucket list. So I used to love, back in the day when I was a kid, I never watched, you know, the all the cartoons or whatever, you know, like, I don't know, whatever popular kids' cartoons in the 90s, I didn't watch them. I always watched
Rocko's Modern Life.
Yeah, and things like that. I mean, I watched a little bit of that. But the point is,
Beavis and Butthead.
Yeah, I didn't watch that one either. 99% of the TV I watched was Discovery Channel and nature documentaries, especially Wild Discovery. That was my favorite series. Discovery Channel, in my opinion, was better than Animal Planet for the nature documentaries, because Animal Planet mostly focused on mammals and birds, which are cool, but I like the reptiles and amphibians better. Anyways, so there's a nice little bay for fishing. It was always on my bucket list since I was 9 years old to see and photograph an eastern diamondback rattlesnake in its natural habitat. And I fulfilled that goal Thanksgiving Day of 2016. I saw a beautiful 3.5-foot eastern diamondback in the patch of, in the acres of woods that I normally go to that's closer to my house. I've only seen three diamondbacks since I've been here. They've proven to be very elusive. So it's kind of hit or miss. All you can do is just kind of go out and look around and just know which habitat you're in. But this island has a very dense population of them. Would you like to see a rattlesnake too, Peter?
That'd be great.
Yeah, I know. I'd really like to see one. I don't know if we are. I mean, we still have time. It's hit or miss. It's like I said, they just spend so much time underground with the tortoises, and they let the tortoise do all the work, and the rattlesnake doesn't pay a single penny of rent.
Sounds like you're a little bitter.
A little bit bitter. This here is perfect to throw out some chum. Look at this, because nighttime and when dusk falls is the best time of day to fish for sharks, or even all the way late into the night too, for that matter. A lot of fishermen will stay out till midnight or even 1 a.m. But yeah, this is the best time when the sharks, the dinner bell rings for the sharks. All right.
It's a wild Seth.
As much as...
Don't move too sudden. Right now, he's looking for food. Preferable food. Has smoked cigars.
All right, that was just leaves rustling. It would have been really cool if it was a rattle, but unfortunately it was not.
We're all done.
Yeah.
We looked at it. We saw it. We didn't find any snakes.
Wait, are you filming now? We did see a lot of alligators earlier today. And then we went to Honeymoon Island. We hiked that trail. It was a really good time.
A little bit awkward because we were just three men in the woods.
We did see some armadillos, though. That was the first time either of these guys have seen armadillos. Peter, this is the first time coming to Florida and actually seeing the true beautiful tranquility that the state has to offer, as opposed to all the mass-produced shoddy cheap crap Mickey Mouse merchandise that you normally see, that people normally come here for, right?
I don't know if I'd use the word.
No, that's what it is. That when you guys hung out with me, you did more than that. We got to see the beautiful.
What do you think about the price of rice in Ethiopia?
Hard to say with all the camel traffic they're having out there. You know, the price of rice has been a
has been fluctuating ever since the Palms tree.
Make sure to follow us at eFilms Travel.
And if, yeah, and hey, no, I'm not done yet.
Okay, see ya.